12th division of the Tuat, which is passed through by the sun god during the 12th hour of the night, is introduced by three lines of text, which read, "The majesty of this great god taketh up his position in this circle, which is the uttermost limit of thick darkness, and this great god is born in his form of Kepra in this circle, and Nut and Nu are in this circle for the birth of this great god when he cometh forth from the Tuat, and taketh up his position in the Metet boat, and when he rises up from the thighs of Nut. The name of the gate of this city is then Neteru. The name of this city is Keeper Kiki Akalmestu. The name of the hour of the night wherein this god cometh into being is Manafert Ra. Above the whole scene is a line of hieroglyphics, which describes it as the hidden circle in the Tuat wherein this great god is born. He cometh forth into the pool of Nu, and he taketh up his place in the body of Nut. Whosoever shall make a copy thereof according to the copies which exist in writing upon the east wall of the palace, and shall know it upon earth, it shall act as a magical protector for him both in heaven and upon earth. In the middle register are 1. The boat of the sun, in which stands the god under a canopy formed by the body of the serpent Mehen. On his head are horns and a disc. In the fore part of the boat is the beetle of Kepra, i.e. Kepra, which takes the place of the solar disc that rested on the prow of the boat in the 11th hour. The text reads, "This great god in this picture journeyeth along through the city by means of the faithful servants, Amkiu, of this hidden image Ankh-Neteru. His gods draw him along by a cord, and he enters into his tail, and cometh forth from his mouth, and cometh to the birth under the form of Kepra, and the gods who are in his boat do likewise. He taketh up his place on the face of the hidden image of the horn, or forehead, of the sky at the end of the thick darkness, and his hands seal lit the Tuat. Then this great god taketh up his position in the eastern horizon of heaven, and Shu receives him, and he cometh into being in the east. 2. 12 gods, who are occupied in towing along the boat of the sun, each with his head turned behind him, and looking at the boat. Their names are 1. Heru. 2. Shemsu. 3. Thina. 4. Bek. 5. Oenkiuf. 6. Sebahuef. 7. Aharer. 8. Amqui. 9. Nebamek. 10. Seki. 11. Heknikmu. 12. O. The text which refers to these reads, "Those who are in this picture draw this great god through the tail, or bowels, of the serpent Ankh-Neteru. The loyal servants of Ra who are in his following are the product of his hands, and they are born on the earth each day after the birth of this great god in the eastern portion of the sky. They enter into this hidden image of Ankh-Neteru in the form of loyal servants, and they come forth in the renewed forms of Ra every day. When they tarry upon the earth, it is an abomination to them to utter the name of the god. 3. The monster serpent Ka-M Ankh-Neteru. 4. 12 goddesses, who are occupied in towing the boat of the sun through the body of the serpent Ka-M Ankh-Neteru. Each has her head turned behind her, and is looking at the boat. Their names are 1. Stat. 2. Karo-Uchit. 3. Kaith. 4. Svert-Neteres. 5. Nedumt. 6. Nebcheta. 7. Hedit. 8. Ankhet-Ermin. 9. Kertip-Tep. 10. Hetep-Em-Kades. 11. Bet-Neteres. 12. Tesseract. The text relating to the serpent reads, "Those who are here are they who have their bodies, and they come forth in the following of this great god into heaven. This is the hidden image of the serpent Ankh-Neteru, which is by his den in the Tuat, and he rests in his place every day. This great god speaketh to him in his name of Na, and the space covered by his forepaws and legs is 1,300 cubits long. He lives upon the sound of the rumblings of the earth. The servants who are loyal to his service come forth from his mouth every day." The text relating to the 12 goddesses reads, "Those who are in this picture take the towing rope of the boat of Ra, when it cometh forth from the serpent Ankh-Neteru, and they tow this great god into the sky, and lead him along the ways of the upper sky. It is they who make to arise in the sky gentle winds and humid breezes, and it is they who order those who live, upon earth, to place themselves in the great boat in the sky. In the upper register are 1. 12 goddesses, each of whom stands upright, and bears on her shoulders a serpent which belches forth fire from its mouth. Their names are 1. Nefert Kau, 2. Kefiut En Ra, 3. Net Sesheshta, 4. Nerfert Hertept, 5. Silichet Eight Bui Pet, 6. Hat Em Taues, 7. Kat Em Sipues, 8. Sekit Em Kues, 9. Hot M. Sipues, 10. K. Thank F, 11. Pert M. Apt, 12. Netter M. Wa Apt. The text reads, "Those who are in this picture with their own bodies, and from whom their urei emerge, are in the following of this great god when he setteth out for this city. They follow after this god, and the flames which issue from their mouths drive away Apep on behalf of Ra into the hall of the east of the horizon. They journey round about the upper heavens in his following, remaining in their places, and they restore these gods after this great god hath passed by the hidden chamber of the sky, and then they take up their positions, again, in their own abodes. They give pleasure to the hearts of the gods of Amentet through Ra Harakut, and their work upon the earth is to drive away those who are in the darkness by the flames of their urei, which are behind them, and they guide Ra along, and they smite Apep for him in the sky. 2. 12 gods, each of whom stands upright, and has both hands raised in adoration before him. Their names are 1. Nebank, 2. Hi, 3. Neba, 4. Nebtuit, 5. Nechimub, 6. Ham, 7. Wab, 8. Hanu, 9. Sensat, 10. Matepinetaru, 11. Bestepineteru, 12. Hikanu. The text reads, Those who are in this picture sing praises unto this great god from dawn, when he taketh up his position in the hall of the east of the sky. They say unto Ra, O thou who art the producer of thine own birth, who dost bring into being thine own being, lord of homage of every soul. Heaven belongeth to thy soul, which taketh up its place therein, and the earth belongeth to thy body, thou lord of homage. Thou sails over the horizon, thou takes up thy place in thy shrine, the gods in their bodies praise thee. Descend thou into the sky, and take thou thy two souls through thy magical protectors. The work of these gods in the Tuat is to praise this great god, and they stand in this city, and they count up, or verify, the gods of the country of Mathgit, i.e., Sinai. They descend to earth, before Ra after he hath taken up his position in the sky and doth rise upon the eyes of mankind in their circles. In the lower register are 1. The god Nu, holding the scepter and Ankh in his left and right hand respectively. 2. The goddess Nut, holding the scepter and Ankh. 3. The god Hehu, holding the scepter and Ankh. 4. The goddess Hehut, holding the scepter and Ankh. 5. The god Tabai, man-headed, and holding an oar, or paddle. 6. The god Kashifshef, man-headed, and holding a paddle. 7. The god Nawi, crocodile-headed, and holding a paddle. 8. The god Anai, with the heads of two birds, and holding a paddle. 9. The deity Nesmekef, in the form of a serpent, which pours forth fire from its mouth. 10. The god Nibaku, man-headed, and holding a paddle. 11. The god Kenti Thathef, man-headed, and holding a paddle. 12. The god Ahab, man-headed, and holding a paddle. 13. The god Tuati, man-headed, and holding a paddle. 14-23. 10 gods, each with his hands raised in adoration. Their names are Tezku, Thema Re, Akibu, Sekenu, Ermenu, Kena Ermen, Bane, Puri, Thep, Am Netter. The texts relating to these gods read, 1. Those who are in this picture in their own bodies join themselves unto Ra in the sky to receive this great god at his coming forth among them in the east of the sky each day. They themselves belong to their halls of the horizon, but the forms which they have in the Tuat belong to this circle. 2, those who are in this picture with their paddles drive a pet to the back of the sky, after the birth of the god. Their work is to hold up the great disc in the eastern horizon of the sky every day. Behold the serpent Senmekef, which burns up the enemies of Ra at the dawn. These gods go round about the heights of heaven in the following of this great god every day, and they receive their protection for this circle. 3. Those who are in this picture are behind the image of Osiris, who is over the thick darkness. These are the words which this god saith unto them after this great god hath journeyed by it. Life to thee, O thou who art over the darkness. Life to thee in all thy majesty. Life to thee, O governor of Amentet, Osiris, who art over the beings of Amentet. Life to thee. Life to thee. O thou who art over the Tuat, the winds of Ra are to thy nostrils, and the nourishment of Keeper is with thee. Thou live, and ye live. Hail to Osiris, the lord of the living, that is to say, of the gods who are with Osiris, and who came into being with him the first time. Those who are behind this hidden image in this circle wherein he live have their nourishment from the words of this god in their own Tuat. 4. He who is in this picture in the invisible form of Horus in the thick darkness, is the hidden image which Shu lifts up beneath the sky, and Kebor cometh forth in the earth in this image. 24. The end of the Tuat, which is represented by a semicircular wall, or border formed of earth and stones, or perhaps granite. At the middle point of this border is the disk of the sun, which is about to rise on this world, and joined to it is the head of the image of Shu, with his arms stretched out along the rounded border of the Tuat. Above his head is the beetle, symbol of Keeper, who has emerged from the boat of the sun god, and below is the image of Auf, that is to say, the body of the night sun god, which has been cast away.